Hello everyone, welcome to my class. In this video, I'll be starting with the age of industrialization, that is class 10th history chapter. And before starting with the book content, let me introduce the theme to you people. In this entire chapter, we'll be discussing about the industrialization, how it started in England and later spread to the Europe and to rest part of the world. Right, so in industrial revolution, the first thing that comes to our mind is the factory system that in which mostly the workers performing or manufacturing the same product under one roof with the help of machinery, a rough picture of factory setup. But before that, there was a phase in England when the early factories, before that, how the manufacturing or how the goods were produced for the market. Even before the factories began to change the landscape in England and Europe, there was a large scale industrial production for an international market. This was not based on factories. Historians refers to this phase of industrialization as proto-industrialization. So before coming up of the factory system, the phase was called the proto-industrialization. It was an initial phase how the idea of factory setup took place. That phase was that initial phase was described as a proto-industrialization phase. In the 17th and 18th century, merchants from towns in Europe began moving to countryside, supplying money to artisans and peasants, persuading them to produce for an international market. The new merchants and traders, not finding any alternative or not finding the workers to produce to make products for them, so this led to their movement towards the countryside. There was a reason behind this movement, as merchants could not expand production within towns and cities. This was because here urban crafts and trade guilds were more powerful. These were associations of producers that trained craft people, maintained control over production, regulate competition and prices, and restricted the entry of the new people into the trade. Rulers granted different guilds the monopoly rights to produce and trade in specific product. Therefore, it was difficult for the new merchants to set up the business in town. So they turned to countryside. Seeing these difficulties, it was really difficult for the new merchants to compete with the guilds or the associations of traders and merchants. They generally don't find workers to produce for them. So they turned to countryside. They started offering money in advance to peasants and artisans who were kept looking for alternative sources of income. Within this system, a close relationship developed between the towns and countrysides. Merchants were based in towns, but the work was done mostly in the countryside. Their finishing was done in London before the export merchants could sold the product in the international market. Mostly when they used to bring the products in the London, then it's a packaging, it's sealing, everything or the finishing of the product was done before setting the product for selling in the international market. So the London became a finishing center. Now, industrial revolution started first of all in England. The industrial revolution began in the later half of the 18th century as favorable conditions for such a development was present there in England. Men like Walpole, who was a great economist, encouraged the foreign trade, which brought more and more wealth to England. The period of time covered by industrial revolution varies with different historians. Eric Horson held that it broke out in the 1780s and was not fully felt until the 1830s or 1840s, while T.S. Ashton held that it occurred roughly between 1760s and 1830. Some 20th century historians such as John Clapham and Nicholas Crafts have argued that the process of economic and social change took place gradually, and the term revolution is not a true description of what took place. This is still a subject of debate amongst historians. This is an additional information which I am giving to you. It is not given in the book. England had developed a large shipping industry which solved their problem of transporting things to distant lands. If you see the England, its position in the map, you'll find that England is surrounded by water from all the sides. So it is having a very good ship industry and navy in the world. The people of England, who were quite enterprising and energetic, also deserved for credit. They worked hard and were ready to take risks. Hargreaves invented the spinning jenny in 1764 AD, which speeded up the spinning work. A little later, John Kay invented the flying shuttle, which speeded weaving. In 1769, Arkwright improved Hargreaves' invention and adopted it in such a way that it could run in by water power. So these were some of the inventions that took place during this century, which helped in the industrial production. Sometime later in 1776, Crompton invented a new machine called the mule, which combined the advantages of both the machines invented by the Hargreaves and Arkwright. In 1785, Cartwright invented power loom, which is used steam power for spinning and weaving purpose. So this is how the different inventions that took place in this century helped in the growth of industries in England. A natural steps in maps progress. The Industrial Revolution was a period in the late 18th and early 19th centuries when major changes in agriculture, manufacturing and transportation had a profound effect on socio-economic and cultural conditions in Britain and subsequently spread throughout Europe and North America and eventually the world, a process that continues as industrialization. The development that took place in England started spreading in the European land and to the different continent of North America, and gradually its effect is seen in rest of the world also. It marked a major turning point in human social history, comparable to the invention of farming or the rise of the first city-states. Almost every aspect of daily life and human society was eventually influenced in some way. In the later part of the 1700, the manual labor-based economy of the Kingdom of Great Britain began to be replaced by one dominated by industry and the manufacture of machinery. So this is how the landscape of England changed from a rural landscape to an industrial landscape. It started with the mechanization of the textile industries, the development of iron making techniques, and the increased use of refined coal. I'll tell you that the northeastern side of England is having a rich deposit of iron ore. So this also helped in the development of industries in England. Trade expansion was enabled by the introduction of canals, improved roads and railways. This also helped in the expansion of the trade in England. Students, we have discussed Industrial Revolution, how it started in England in this video, and in other videos we'll be continuing with the chapter further. Thank you for watching this video.